Hey guys, it's Broker Prayers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Olympic Must Take Career Mode, where last month left off. I continue my elite performances. We may have taken a step closer to learning who will be the top goal scorer come the end of the season, because a fantastic hat trick in the last episode will point to Stephen Fletcher, put his name in the conversation. But I feel easy to bolster for Bashua. He also put his name in contention as well.
Here's the Bastia lineup for you. With the way this
management will have to at least get us to the January transfer window, because the window officially closed in the last episode. So this is, we're now into September. The first image of this episode you can see is in, I think it's pronounced Bastia.
Time out in that away victory.
So hoping to continue my form and win 5 on the trot. Also, if I'm not mistaken, I think I have my first Europa League match in this episode as well. So kicking off my attempts to
strong, powerful clearance.
Say their first Europa trophy and their first European silverware since their one Champions League win. And I bet there's a lot of people saying to themselves, Marseille won the Champions League. Yeah. For those non-historians and non-Marseille fans, yes, Marseille, they did win. Our one-time winner is a.
Diallo. It's crossed it well.
The Champions League. So, look to get the opportunity to add the Europa League trophy to the old trophy cabinet of Marseille as well.
This could be it.
Special IE. Ball is taken from my hand clear, but it's going to come back. Toe back.
Not a good challenge by the defender. Shot up!
Why didn't I pass it?
Very good intercepting play there to get his positional situation right and win the ball without too much effort. Aite. Well, he's pressed him there to running the ball out of play. Michy Batshuayi. Ball played to Mendy.
Still can't pronounce this guy's name.
Cross it.
Although, if I have the right player, this guy might be going to Spurs. The guy out in the wing. And Kudu. He might be going to Spurs for close to 11 million. Well, 10.8, but it's close to 11 million. I mean, like 2. Fuck. 200.
Okay. Well, they kept up the pressure, didn't they? But it's finally
so interesting. Little development. It seems Marseille are hell bent on powering up the Premier League this season. Anyway, that's why he already gone to
defender to it first.
Chelsea, and Kudu, who might be going to
goes.
The Spurs. And I found out where Steve Mandanda went. Yeah, he's gone to Crystal Palace. Not sure or why that didn't come up at any point. But, yeah. He's going to be Crystal Palace's goalkeeper next season. Not sure what. I know one reported on that because I did not hear about it. It was talked about, which was, oh, he's at Crystal Palace. Just brush over that. Really good goalkeeper going to the team in that. No. Our goalkeepers aren't bad for the Crystal Palace, but Steve Mandanda will do him, you know, will get him a fair amount of clinch. He's on his own, he's a very good keeper. Pardon me. He was a keeper, or I was actually, considering having at Liverpool. Well, not just us in my career, but in general. Well, I would have been very happy if Liverpool signed him, but I would make Duke carriers because when he stopped joking around in preseason, it would be a fantastic addition to the team. And yes, I am sure he is only joking. At least I hope he's only joking. There's a little mix-up against Wigan.
Diallo.
Sure, as a lot of you were probably saying to yourself, it's not. And those of you who would probably not be a Liverpool fan.
The Wayside have some more action to come. This is it. And this is their fixture in League One.
I'll take that free kick. Hey, yeah, yellow card. Okay, Hacken, you are up. Do what you need to do. Oof!
It
was on target. I'm getting closer. I feel like he will score a free kick with Çalhanoğlu before the end of this career. Because I seem to get very close with him. He's very good at them. I don't know why it took me until my second last secondary career mode for free to put the 16 to use him. Although, the one time I needed a cam, I was happy with the choice that I made. That was, of course, in the last career mode.
Switch on the attack.
I won't tell you who I did you lose, but because there's a lot you probably send yourself, before you ever shut up about who good you think that player is. Because there are other players in the game, and that's true, there are. I won't just talk about him anymore, I'll just hate that. He is a very good choice, but also a good choice is Hakan Çalhanoğlu because he can do shit like that. It took 83 minutes to break these pricks down. But hey, that's a fantastic goal. Well, he finesse shot right into the top corner. Or does. The best goals I've scored in this career mode. Then again, that's not saying a lot. Not really scored anything special as we get in this career mode. Bashawayi might make it 2-0 and wrap up the points, and he has. Best year of it. A goal and an assist for Hackett, who in the the blink of an eye, tonight it's gone from 0-0 to 2-0.
Fantastic.
Sebastian, he takes the lead in the race for top goal scorer. Of course, Honolulu's goal was his second of the season. So maybe he will have a say in top goal scorer for the season.
Like this, they certainly can't.
Yeah, who knows?
I wonder what this manager's going to do, whether he'll go route one, aerial barrage into the box, because the previous tactic.
Of course, Stephen Fletcher wants to get his name on the score sheet, but he's not going to do that, probably. At least not in this match, because that foul will mean they clear the ball, and chances are I won't get it to him in time. Wait, here we go. Whoa. There's a chance! Go Fletcher! Oh, he's denied by a fantastic save. There's still a chance. It's come to Hakan Çalhanoğlu. Oh, and he buries it for three. Hey.
Just lays it into the corner.
That is definitely man of the match for Hakan Çalhanoğlu. A goal and two goals and an assist. I'm getting confused. Not sure why. I'm actually surprised that Bastia White didn't take the ball. Why? I was actually kind of expecting it to switch me to Bastia White. But no, it kept me on Çalhanoğlu. For once, it didn't try to screw me over. Or by randomly changing the play for the last fucking second.
I don't think we expected this. Such a one-sided affair, but look at the scoreline.
There's the full time whistle. Well, the third goal was just to pile on the misery. The channel, of course, did get man of the match. There you go. 9.8. I mean, two goals in it. This says a lot. In fact, all the assists came from the midfielders, which who in the R getting the other assists. And of course, Bastia White got the other goal. Well, between the two goals for Çalhanoğlu. Now, if Bordeaux could do me a big favor and take points off PSG, that'd be fantastic. PSG have already dropped points this season, because they're only on 10 before this match. Not tied with me as I would expected. So they did drop points at some point. I don't know who they dropped points to, but I don't suppose that's important. Let's see. Oh wow, they did take points off them. Thank you, Bordeaux.
15 points in second. That's
fantastic. PSG. Although I've been wrong so far. I thought Ajax would provide a better competition in the Dutch.
In seventh, Bordeaux with 6 points.
Dutch career mode. I was wrong. I was right with Bayern challenging me in
with 2 points.
The Bundesliga, and I was wrong with who would challenge me in the Serie A. But, so far, PSG have already dropped 4 points, which isn't exactly a typical PSG start. They don't drop any kind of points whatsoever. Which means the top four going into the next game will be in that order. That's ironic, considering who is behind me, Saint-Étienne. Because I just found out, they hold the record for the most Liga titles at 10. And it was right behind them, Marseille with 9. So, yeah, that's a little interesting tidbit if we can get. For those who didn't know, there's probably a lot of people going like, wow, did not know that. That's an interesting little tidbit. Lyon. Of course, that's the next episode. Lyon and Toulouse. Yay! But of course, I have to play Krasnodar. Who are Russians? I have no... I have nothing that says for sure that they're Russian, but their name seems Russian. Maybe I'm misjudging them. Even their, look at the writing on their badge. It's almost Russian style. Oh. No, it's not exactly coming out the way I want it to be worded. I think they're Russian. If I have to guess, I'm gonna say that they're Russian. If I'm wrong, I'll admit it, but they seem Russian. I mean, I haven't done a Russian career mode in who knows how long. And they are Russian. Brilliant. Fantastic. Great guessing work on my part. So, yay! I got the what country these guys are from? Incorrect. First time. Brilliant. Polishing up the diamond in midfield
in a 4-4-2 formation. Yeah, and the man at the forward point of that diamond, Martin, behind the two strikers, he's important. He can make things happen.
Great save by a diving goalkeeper.
What a good piece of defensive clearance that was.
Sir.
Shots on.
Stewart. Look, Campos puts it in, and we have our first goal in the Europa League in the 8th minute. Fantastic. 8 minutes into the first game. And Mustafa's shot was not really that powerful. I should put more power into it and give the keeper some bit for to work with. But, hey, if I hit harder, he might not have parried it, and Campos may not have scored. So, every cloud has a silver lining in that situation, doesn't it? It's Petrov. Of course, it's not.
Petrov.
Well, he is coming. He might be coming back, actually, to Aston Villa. Still in Petrov, because we're talking about players with the initials SP. Yeah, that's how desperate Aston Villa are. They're bringing back a guy who had something more important to do. You know, like, not die from leukemia.
Now he's looking for some support. Here's the cross. Good hands. Bread and butter work really.
Imagine that phone call between Di Matteo and Petrov. Hello, Petrov, can you come back and, you know, and save us from the situation who we got ourselves into? Ooh, and there was no one else was doing.
Petrov
was really like, focusing on, you know, recovering from, you know, leukemia, that, you know, that disease that can kill a person if not treated correctly and all that good stuff. So you know, I'll think about it, but I wouldn't hold my breath. But obviously he eventually did say yes. I don't know if he said yes or not. Okay, that's hypothetical, that little conversation there. I don't know why it's random shit, you know. That's why you all clicked on that subscribe button. I'm fantastically random at all times.
and the ball goes out for a goal kick.
You know, so what, you know, if you want to hit it next time and actually try and get us a goal, that'd be fantastic.
He's lost control.
Last year. Los Campos! Oh, you freaking idiot! You freaking idiot! How did you miss? Oh, did I put too much power into it? Dongu. I don't even know what to say about that. I really don't.
Paolo De Cecchi.
Foul. Take it quick. Catch him off guard. Go. Someone get into the box. Fantastic. There's no one there. Fantastic. There's no one there. May as well be a slow man.
Throw for Marseille. Charles Cabore.
Well, hey, that's a random throw which I will take happily. Seriously, why did they give me that throw? Oh, and I've returned the favor. Brilliant! Fantastic. Big work there, gentlemen. That whole sequence was pointless.
No delay here.
Except it did do one thing, it's pretty much gotten us to halftime on this. No, they're not going to take it quickly. Forcing to take the long run. There's the halftime whistle. Interesting to see the other game. And Sampdoria are being Gothenburg. Who I think are Swedish? I might be wrong. Maybe they're German? It could be German. I don't know. It could be Swedish, it could be German. I don't know. Oh, what do you people
want? There seemed to be a bit of tension in the air early on in the first half, especially.
Handball. I just realized I'm calling for handball, they're not. I don't know why. Go. Go, Los Campos. Yes.
And the ball's got away from it.
Free. Of course not.
Manager thinking from the wayside, time for a change. They're going to start from the back. It's a back pass to the keeper.
Yes! Munir! Whips it in! No, he... what a shit cross! I could have done better myself! Oh, nice. Suck at playing football in real life. I'd be a terrible player, but I'd put a better cross than that.
And then he went, just diverted it away.
Yes, put it back. And we lost it again. Fantastic.
And their signing, which is now confirmed. Well, it's a fairly big transfer figure, £40 million or thereabouts, and I think this lad won't be affected by it, though. He'll,
yes! Go on, Dongu! Into position. Los Campos for the second! No! You are all terrible!
They allowed the striker to...
Let's switch it up, see what I can do. I've not been impressed with Dungu, to be honest. And... can we play on the wing, perhaps? Let's put him on for Sar. And, that'll be good.
To go and free.
Change up the options, because the options I have aren't good enough. I may have to use some of this money to strengthen the second team in the January transfer window. And Dungu's last participation in this game is to concede a free kick. Rolando. Lucas.
Intercepting play there.
Sorry. No wait, Lucas is his first name. I can pass it off! Right there! Oh!
It's a wonderful save.
Sorry, that was Mastier. I don't know what. I assumed it was Minier. Sorry. My bad. I should pay more attention. I just hit it. I didn't pay attention to who was hitting it. Omrimi. That time it would have been Minier, but he didn't connect with it properly.
Well, this is fascinating, and the crowd are loving the...
Rolando again. Os Campos, come on. His second goal.
Celebrating too quickly and that the...
Oh! Friggin' hell, that was almost an own goal. What the hell was that guy doing? I like that didn't count as a back pass this game.
Coming up for you on EA Sports, this is the fixture for the home side, their next game in Ligue 1.
Gerarda. Bro, I'm on. If he scores, I'll start him in the next Europa League game. He might set up a goal. Penalty! You freaking asshole!
He's moved in trying to jostle the opponent off his stride.
Great challenge by my left back. Had to... prevent the attack from building up steam. Silva wins the ball back. And there's the full-time whistle, even though I was on an attack, so you can't blow the whistle. Prick. ...7.5 was my highest rating. And I'm pretty sure Os Campos only got a 7.5 because he got the goal. This team was pathetic. Look at that. The keeper of the opposition team got a 9.7. Hang on a second. I know that keeper. Isn't that the keeper I was using in my Braga career mode? Chris... UK. Krusty. I don't know how to pronounce his name, but that might be the same guy. And of course, Sampdoria got a second goal, which means I'm second.
Euro,
which isn't good enough. Well, I'm glad you're happy with yourself. Both because you were all freaking terrible. You weren't good enough.
The age. Yeah. Villarreal 1, Bordeaux 1.
This second team, it's lacking something. When I figure out what, I'm gonna scour for the players at my disposal, which is everyone, by the way. Maybe I'll look back and see who performed the worst according to the game. And figure out what went wrong. Why didn't I get... I'm not sure why. I did switch it back, but for some reason it didn't register that I switched it back. Brilliant. So, on that, I'm going to call that successful disappointment, because I did win the match, but I didn't exactly, you know, I didn't feel like, you know, I had more shots, and, you know, it didn't feel like I was really in control of that match. Something didn't click with that second team. I mean, the only reason I'm playing the second team is because otherwise everyone would freaking get super tired and then I'd be freaking fuming. So in the January transfer window, I will have to look into signing a new player. I'm gonna have to somehow put the terribleness of the second team out of my mind. When I get to that game against Montpellier, yeah, the second team isn't playing that. The Europa League games, I have no choice but to play them. But this Copa del Rey match, yeah, the first team will be playing that. Chances are there will be another Copa del Rey game between now and January. Between then and January. But that's not for now, that's for the near future. Speaking of the near future, smash the like button, subscribe. Hey, make sure to tune back in for tomorrow's video. Oh, and until then, I will see you. I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.